everyone, it's Missy. Welcome back to my channel. Today's tutorial is from a picture I posted on Instagram. Make sure to like and subscribe and click that notification bell so you never miss any future videos. And let's get started. For this hairstyle, I've parted my hair on the right side as I usually do. I always like to spray my part with some hairspray to try and tame down any flyaways. So next I'm going to divide off a section of hair at my crown and pin this in place at the center back of my head. This will make it easier to create some volume at the crown of my head. So I'm just going to slide a couple bobby pins horizontally over the section and then gently pull on small pieces of hair at the crown to add some volume and also ensure that it's symmetrical. Next, I'm going to divide off a small section of hair on the right side of my head directly in front of the crown section that I just pinned. I'm going to spray this with hairspray and then smooth it down with my fingers. And I'm just going to twist the section together in an upwards direction and then lay it across the bobby pins from the crown section. I'm going to pin the section with some bobby pins and I'm just sliding them into the hair so that they don't show. And then I'm going to go back over the section and gently pull on the edges so the twist is a lot fuller. And now I'm going to pick up a similar section on the left side of my head, right in front of the crown section, and I'm going to repeat the same steps, twisting the section upwards and draping it underneath the previously pinned section. I'm just going to secure it in place with some bobby pins and then go back over the section, pulling on the edges so the twist is a lot fuller. And to keep the style clean, I'm also going to spray it with some medium hold hairspray and then just smooth down any loose pieces as I go. So now I'm going to take another section on the right side of my head, right in front of the previous section, and I'm going to repeat the same steps again, twisting the section upwards. Then drape it underneath the previously pinned sections and then secure it in place with some bobby pins. You just want to make sure to use as many bobby pins as you need for each of these twists. This will just ensure that it stays in really well. I like to slide them into the twist so they're only gripping a few pieces of hair, but they'll stay hidden really well this way. And then of course, once it's pinned, I'm going to go back over the twist and pull on the edges to add some volume and make it fuller. And it will also give the overall hairstyle a looser and softer look. And then I'm just going to take the final section of hair from the left side of my head, right in front of the previous sections, twist the hair together again, and I'm also going to pull on the edges to add some volume to the twist like I did before, and then just pin it in place with some bobby pins. Now I'm going to divide out a section of hair at the center back of my head right underneath the twists. I'm going to divide this into three pieces and braid this into a fringe braid. So I'm going to start by crossing the left strand over the middle and then cross the right strand over the middle. Then I'm going to cross the left strand over the middle, pick up a new section of hair right next to the braid on the left side and cross it over the middle strand as well. Then I'm going to cross the right strand over the middle, pick up a new section of hair on the right side of the braid and cross it over the middle strand, bringing it into the braid. And then I'm going to cross the left strand over the middle, pick up a new section of hair on the left side and cross it over the middle strand as well. And then I'm going to cross the right strand over the middle, pick up a new section on the right side of the braid and cross it over, bringing it into the braid.
I like to bring in fairly large sections. This will give the braid a looser, softer effect. You can bring in smaller pieces if you'd like. It would make the braid a little bit more detailed. Either way, it will look beautiful. It's totally up to you. So then once all of the hair is brought into the braid, I'm just going to do two more stitches of the braid, crossing the left over the middle and then the right strand over the middle. And then to finish the braid, I'm going to take the left side strand and I'm going to wrap it around the bottom of the braid two times. And then I'm going to grab a clear elastic band and tie it around the bottom of the braid, making sure to include the ends from this wrapped piece. And then the clear elastic band will hold it in place, wrapped around the bottom of the braid. And then to finish the style, I'm just going to go back over the braid and gently pull on the edges, as I always do, so that the braid is a lot fuller and bigger. This will help the braid show up a little bit better, and it will also give the overall hairstyle a looser and softer look. And then I'm just going to spray the style with a medium hold hairspray and smooth down any flyaways.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Make sure to like and subscribe and click that notification bell so you never miss any future videos. And I will see you next time.